TV and stuff. Let's fix that one. I don't mean it for the show. I get it. You're good. Physics. Good. All right. So, for upper extremity, biomechanical change. I want to physically alter this bone in his arm. Now, this is just one joint, because we all know that the spine can have an effect on his motion, ACSE can have an effect, scap can have an effect. So let me physically move something. For this example, to make this go quicker, because we're supposed to do the ankle today, let's just pick GH. So, lift up your arm. Good. Now he has, looks like, pretty normal range of motion, so I'm not too concerned, but maybe he says, ouch, or that was difficult. So then we're gonna come back, go here, all I'm gonna do is stabilize so I don't do this to him, and I'm going to push that humerus back, and then do it again. Good, and all I care about is that better, worse, or the same? Same or worse, okay, I was wrong. Better, okay, I'm gonna go have you lay down and check that out now, because I have other stuff to do, but you get the idea. I have to check out the GH joint, because for some reason now that's better. Either increased his range, increased his decreased his pain, or was easier for him. So something to do with this position was not ideal, if that helped him. So that's the upper extremity biomechanical correction. So now we're gonna do external stabilization. So this is no longer physical. My hand's on, yes, but all I want him to do is activate muscles. So with this, since we're gonna stick to glenohumeral joint, all I'm gonna do is I want these muscles to suction cup his arm into the socket. So all I'm gonna do is be here, and do you feel how I'm pulling you away? Mm-hmm. I want you to resist me, pull towards the socket, good. Hold that contraction the whole time, and I want you to lift up your arm over your head. And then that's it. I don't know how much you can see this, but I'm gonna move his shirt the amount of pressure that I'm giving him. That's it. That's how much pressure it is. All it is it's more directional. I probably should have even been like this so I can get out of your way. But all it is gently pull away. You can see how physically I'm doing this, is that. And he's pulling against me just to get the direction correct. And I'm in a position where I can move with them. And that's it. Very light. It gets better? Great. I need to look at muscles with him. Is it strength? Is it stabilization? Or is it coordination? Motor control? Let's see. He says it's better. What I want you to do is gently imagine there's a string here and pull this bone into your socket. I'm doing this quick. And then lift up. Yep, that's great. Okay, I'm gonna use those cues later for when we do the breakout to see if he can do it on his own, and can he do it for 10 seconds on, 10 seconds off, 2 minutes, those little parameters. If he can't pick things up and put them down, then we can go into your one rep max, 80%, and look into strength training. All right, so that's stabilization, motor control, and biomechanical correction for the GH. Wonderful. So now let's do the lower extremity. So let's use the hip as an example. His problem is a squat. So if we have, whether it's an active or passive problem, certainly active, we're gonna look at our cueing and our stabilization, but biomechanical correction, it is physical. So I'm gonna put my hand on the front of your hip. Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna get on to the front of the femoral head, and I am going, my hand's here, so I don't do this again. I'm going to push, or pull, I'm not pushing, pull him backwards, pull that femur back. That is a physical correction. And now I'm gonna have you sit down and let me know, pain, easier, harder, or is it better motion? Yes, no, and if it's better, great, I need to check out his hip. Why did that help him? I don't know yet. External stabilization. I'm gonna have my hand on your butt, is that all right?
Yeah. Okay.
So you're gonna find the sit bone. I want you to just gently sit back into my hand, a little too less aggressive, you're heavy, I'm not that strong. Good. I want you to hold that the whole time. Ready? And then I want you to keep that contraction and lower yourself down. Good. And then up. So all it was is having him activate those areas. You could even do a lift, so you have the compression, you have the pull, and then cueing, you can get the bone into the socket. So what I want you to do is imagine the bone inside this joint pulling in towards the socket, and then squat, and that's your cueing. One is stabilization, one is physical, and the other is verbal. And then you need to look at the joint, and that's how we go into column three. You do a destabilization breakout if this helped, motor control breakout if the words help, articular breakout, especially if you if that physical correction helped.
If the physical correction helped and the external state helped, are you still assessing the joint?
Yes.
Or you just focus on that?
Do both. You just have two breakouts to do now. That's it. Because you're allowed to have both both problems contributing to the issue. That was a quick version, but does that help go in the direction we want to go?
Mm-hmm.
So you're saying that you could potentially have two breakouts, but would we have to assess which one is more of the priority, or just go?
Yeah, we're going to lead you in a direction on a test,
but you know.
Yeah. I need to check out the joint for X, Y, and Z reason. I need to check out the muscles for this reason, because both of them helped you with that squat. Maybe you need to clear up the joint before it's a muscle problem. Maybe not. I don't know. As long as you have a reason to look at it. Maybe your breakout, you find it's negative, and that's fine too.